And welcome to another Friday book review. Today I have one book for you, but it kind of goes along with the pioneer theme, only coming a very different angle than what I'm used to, and I absolutely loved it. The book is A Sky Full of Song by Susan Lynn Meyer. And what I love about this book is that it actually takes place in 1905, but you get a little bit of world history along with pioneer life and so many other topics. I'm going to start with my two content considerations, and at the end I'll tell you some of the redeeming things about this book. My only two concerns about this book is one time it does take the Lord's name in vain. If I was going to read it aloud, I would just skip over that or alternate the word. However, if it's you're going to give it to your child and it's your copy, you will want to mark that out or just tell them to skip over it. The other content consideration is that it does talk about a young girl starting her cycle. Not that that precludes it, but it may preclude it from you giving it to your young boys. Or if you have not had the talk yet with your children, you may not want to give it to your young daughter. Yes, it does. It gives it pretty detailed, not super graphic, but detailed enough that it would be shocking if they hadn't heard about it. So A Sky Full of Song takes place in 1905. So you're actually getting in at the end of the pioneer days. Now, we love Little House on the Prairie. We love Prairie Lotus. We love several different pioneer stories. Caddy Woodlawn, Kevin Face West. I mean, there's just so many pioneer stories. It's one of the things, you know, that's the older men in our generation above me had their westerns. My generation had our pioneer girl books, and I love so many of them. And this one is a newer one, and I love how it comes across. So this takes place in 1905, and it follows a Jewish Ukrainian family who are escaping Ukraine because of the persecution there. So you're already going to get to talk to that. If you have also talked about another good one for that time period, it's Words on Fire by Jennifer Nielsen, and that kind of gets into the Cossacks and the Russian oppression of various people groups. And it would be a good combo with this, but for maybe a little older grade. I would give this, if you've had the talk with your child, as young as fourth grade. But as an adult, I enjoyed it too, so it's all the way up. But this is 1905, and they're leaving Ukraine to come to America. And so you will talk about topics of anti-Semitism in various locations throughout this story and how this young girl really comes to terms with who she is in her faith and in her family and how to be proud of her faith. As a Christian reading this, I would like to say I'm shocked at the manner that the so-called Christians treat the Jewish people, but I'm not. But it may be shocking for your children. And if you haven't talked about persecution or accepting other people groups, then this will be a big discussion point for you. And talking about what is a true Christian and why, and just how people's behavior, talking about how you react to one another, how we interact with one another, how we can respect and love one another despite our differences. So many great topics in here. Topics of family, topics of community, of new beginnings. And it's very well written. It's a quick read. It's one that I think my girls will enjoy. We are studying the 19th century right now, and I will probably save this for the end of the year as a family read aloud, or possibly a beginning read or summer read for us, because it does technically take place in 1905, and we try to follow that with our reading, though we're a bit everywhere. But if you are looking for a pioneer story from a unique perspective, then I suggest A Sky Full of Song, which comes from a Jewish immigrant perspective, which is one I have not seen yet. If you are looking for other Jewish immigrant perspectives, there are several other great books out there. I recently read, and I believe I shared on here, Broken Strings, and also, what's it called? It's The Family. There's a lot of them. But you will want to look, what is it called now? All of Kind Family. You'll want to look up All of a Kind Family, which they are not necessarily immigrants, their parents were, and that takes place in the 1900s, but it is a wonderful also Jewish immigrant story. And my kids have loved all of those books. So I highly recommend A Sky Full of Song for grades 4 and up if you're comfortable with them. Knowing about women's menstrual cycles is the biggest content consideration there for you to think about before you hand it over to your child. And again, just mention that it does take the Lord's name in vain. That's wrong. You may want to cover it up. You may want to substitute. But I highly recommend this book. It is wonderful. All right, well, have a great day, and I'll see you again next week for hopefully another Friday book review.